Good morning to the second year students. There's inflammation. I already read your well-known topics to you. This is the first year topics. So right now we have to study the review of this topics in method. In first unit, these topics will be appear. So we'll be reviewing these topics and remember these topics because it is a basis for you. So we have to definitely, you have to keep it in mind. Definitely your inflammatory reactions and infection reaction will be you can able to write very clearly. So inflammation means it is an act of inflaming or state of being inflamed. Actually, it is a process by which bodies, WBCs and some of the chemicals will protect us from the our body's own WBCs and some of the chemicals, some of the proteins which protects us from the infection and foreign substances such as bacteria, virus, all these things. Actually, it is characterized by the pain, redness and swelling and loss of function. It is a, not only that, it is a source of biologicals, like a patient will be having a redness, heat and swelling itself. Causes means mainly physical causes, chemical causes, infections, ischemia and immune. Main physical causes are environmental, that may be a mechanical. In environmental, heat and cold substances. Mechanical, some of the car accidents, injuries, assaults. So this will called as assault. Assaults means man, what we call man will man creating things, and what a mechanical, and then chemicals means burns, drugs, snake venom, acid. Infections means bacteria, virus and fungus. And ischemia, you know, decreased blood supply to the infant. So whenever there is a decreased blood supply, it is called as ischemia. And immune disorders, some of the autoimmune, self-immune suppressing disorders, and some of the allergies. So autoimmune disorders. So this will come. And we are having a type, will come with the types of inflammations. In types of inflammations, acute, chronic and subacute. In acute, it is characterized by the local vascular and exudate changes. Local and vascular exudate changes can be seen. It can be last than for 2 weeks only. It is an immediate response and serve protective function. It is an immediate response to the inflammation and serves for the protective function. When the agent is removed, the inflammation can be subside in case of acute stages. Actually, it is characterized by local vascular exudate changes, and it lasts for only 2 weeks. It is an immediate response and serve protective function. Agent removed. Whenever the agent is removed, the inflammation subsides. In chronic, it develops when injurious agent persists. So here when the it develops when the chronic stages, it may takes for months to years. It develops when the injurious substances is persisting in our body. It may takes for months to years to heal. It is called as a chronic. It begins insidiously, and the chronic stages occur at the site of injury. So wherever the site of injury will be there, at the stage only the stages can be. Exudates become proliferates. This exudates, whatever these exudates will be there, it will be proliferated. Proliferated means it can spread. It can spread to the other parts also, and it can proliferate, it can infiltrate deep into the tissues and form as a necrosis and also form as a fibrosis. Lastly, it may represent as a scarring. It leads to the permanent tissue damage also. So in chronic stages, these are the stages: proliferation, infiltration, necrosis and fibrosis, and scarring stages. It leads to the permanent damage of the tissue. In case of subacute, it fall between acute and chronic. It is an active, it has an active exudate phase. It is also active acute response as well as element repair. It may be having element repaired as in the chronic phase. So here, this is a subacute. It is falls between the acute and chronic stage. It is an acute. And coming to the stages. In case of stages, we are having a tissue injury, release of chemicals and leukocytic migrations. The tissue, whenever the inflammation occurs or bacteria or anything, it can, because of this physical or chemical or the infection reactions, the tissue may got damaged. You had seen in the atherosclerosis that you remember that one. So whenever the tissue get injuries, the release of chemicals, there will be release of chemicals, proteins, all this will get released. After that, this leukocytes and microcytes will migrate. So these are the three stages we can see in this inflammatory reactions. And then coming to the tissue healing, whenever, how tissue will get healed. So collagen formation is nothing, collagenation is nothing but regeneration of the new tissue. So whenever we take the treatment or anything implemented at that time, regeneration of the new tissue, after regeneration of the new tissue, definitely it requires blood supply. So it may angiogenesis means revascularization. So vascularity will be increased. After that, proliferation has to take place. After that, proliferation means granulation tissue will be formed. So proliferating tissue and remodeling. So remodeling means regaining to the normal stage. So these are all the stage. First of all, new tissue has to develop, vascularity has to increase. Whenever this new tissue and vascularity has increased, this granulation tissue will spread, proliferate. The granulation tissue form. After that, the it will come to the normal stage. So we are having a treatment. What is that? We are giving NSAIDs. So NSAIDs, some of the corticosteroids in case of prostaglandins release, in case of this prostaglandins get released in case of in this stage. So at that time, some of the NSAIDs, corticosteroids can be advised, and antihistamines can be given. If necessary, we have to advise them cold and hot therapy. So this is the stages. So we'll see how the stages it clearly. The tissue injury, release of chemicals, and leukocytic migration. So release of chemicals in the local effect area, like histamines, prostaglandins, leukoterins, and complement, etc. It can be released. Whenever it can be released, there will be a vasodilatation of the blood vessel. So whenever there is a dilation, the blood flow to the injured area will be increased. Whenever it has been increased, it will feel some of the heat, and then temperature and basal metabolic rate also will be increased. So here afterward, increased capillary permeability, vascular vasodilatation, capillary permeability will be increased. Allowing into the capillaries can be increased. Whenever it increases, capillary leak fluid. So capillary fluid will leak and form as an exudate. So because of this, there will be nutrients, oxygen variable for tissue repair, and protein rich fluid accumulated in area. So this will be exudates will be O2 rich, and then protein rich and clotting protein from the blood escapes into the tissues. Example, fibrinogens. So these fibrinogens will escape from the tissues. Whenever this fibrinogens will escape, it leads to the blood clot. So fibrinogen is a very important thing, no? And not only that, whenever this oxygen has been escaped, and then proteins rich fluid can be seen, it may lead to the edema and represent as a pain. So this will be due to increased permeability only, the pain, edema, and blood clot can be seen. Because of not only that, chemotaxis. So chemotaxis is nothing but WBCs are injured at area. So the WBCs will become, WBCs will protect us from the infection. So these will become, when they attack this by chemicals, it will also get injured. At that time, what will be happening? We'll see. So we had seen this tissue injury, and then chemotaxis. So after that, leukocyte migration. So what will happen in leukocyte migration? Release of leukocytes. So leukocytes will release, because of release, the WBCs will migrate to the injured area. So because of injury, when the injury, alternately there will be WBCs injured. So not only that, when migration occurs, lastly, this WBCs will migrate migrate to the injured area. Whenever this migration occurs, WBCs in the endothelium of the capillary walls can be seen. And then diapases, migration of the immigration of the WBCs, they will crawl through the capillary wall. Phagocytosis of the dead tissues. So there will be phagocytosis and leads to pus formation. This area is cleared by debris. So this is the stages of inflammatory stages. We'll go with the infection. So the infection is an infection and invading of the body by pathogens or microorganisms capable of producing disease. The organisms which are capable of producing disease will invade our body and leads to the infection. So this is the infection. Infection means there is an the pathogen or microorganisms will invade our body and capable of producing diseases. So we are having a source of infection like bacteria, virus and contaminated objects or articles. So person's his own normal flora is also responsible, and innominate objects also will lead to the infection. So definitely the entry and multiplication of the disease producing agents in the body. So this infection, then we'll have a mode of transmission. How it will be transmitted? Mode of transmission, by direct contact, by contact transmission. So contact transmission has a direct contact and indirect contact. And one more reason, droplet transmission. So directly by touching the objects we can have, directly by touching the objects which is used by the infected patients or infected that thing, and indirectly we used to touch because of that also. Droplet infection, droplet transmission means through the droplets. Airborne means which it can be stayed in the air. Whenever the air also leads to vehicle transmission, means vehicles and transmission is with some objects. The salmonella, handling contaminated chicken. So this is one of the example. Vector transmission means they will require one source to transmit the disease. That is nothing but vector transmission. We can take it as an example, mosquito. This droplet transmission and airborne, we can take it as a corona infection. So this is this mode of transmission, how it will be transmitted. So this is a thing. And chain of infection. In chain of infection, we are having an infectious agent. So infectious agent means bacteria, that may be a bacteria, that may be a virus, that may be a fungus or parasites or disease, that will multiply and enter into the tissues and leads to this thing. And it requires any reservoir. It requires any reservoir. Reservoir means it requires microorganisms will live there. It requires will leave. Reservoir means it will leave and reproduce and multiply more and more. Like we can take it as reservoirs like water or tabletops or doormats and all the things. So portal of exit. Microorganisms leave from the reservoir. When they will leave means when they sneezes, then the infected person from the infected persons they will exit. How they will exit means the microorganism leave. So sneezes, coughs, when the feces, it may from there it will use. And mode of transmission. Mode of transmission means it is also transfers the microorganisms from one place to another place by healthcare workers or anything. And entry of the host, it may enter into the body orifices, mucosal membranes and the skin. So it may get stagnated over here, and the person and the susceptible host means the person who cannot resist. So the person, they cannot resist the microorganisms and it will definitely invade our body. So in portal of entry we are having natural orifices, artificial orifices, mucosal membranes and skin breaks. So in natural orifices we are having ear, mouth, nose, urethra, ear, and artificial orifices, mucosal membrane, skin. So we can take a chain of infection. We can take it as an example of the corona. Infectious agents means we are having a coronavirus. In that coronavirus, it is a reservoir. It will leave in our my mucosa membranes of the nose and eyes also. So after that, it may whenever we infected person sneezes or coughs, whenever in case of urine is also one of the thing, no? So whenever he is there, so it may transmit to one place to another place with the help of, it may by touching our objects, inanimate objects, all these things are not, if not, healthcare workers are also responsible for to transfer. So from there we'll get transfer. So when it may enter into the next person's mouth, and then next person's nostrils, and then ears, and then he may not able to suspend, he may become the susceptible host. So this is the thing. Breaking of the chain. So how we have to break? So infectious agents. So definitely bacteria, virus, rapid accumulation identification. Definitely we have to identify the infection. And we have to identify, and then reservoir people, equipment. So definitely we have to have an environmental sanitization, disinfection, sterilization. So this should be there. So to prevent to break chain over here. And then portal of entry, when the infection has entered over here, so we have to break chain over here by maintaining a proper attire. So our proper attire by hand washing, controlling excretions and secretions, and trash outing the waste material disposal. And then what, not only that, means of transmission, how they will transmit it. It may be a direct or through the ingestion. So we have to isolate them. So we have to isolate the persons or anything. Airflow should be controlled. So at portal of entry, whenever it will get, so we can break chain over here also. So by maintaining the wound care, aseptic care, and catheter care, so by maintaining this, we can prevent this infection. When the susceptible infection is there, we have to treat first of all underlying cause. Because whenever the person microorganism, he is a susceptible immune suppression. Disorders and diabetes, burns, or surgery, or any cardiopulmonary diseases. So we have to treat the underlying cause, and then we have to go for that. So you can take it as nowadays you can get the indirect question as how to break how to break the chain of infection in corona. If you get this type of question, you have to draw this and you have to show the things. So infectious agents mean that may be a coronavirus, and then how we can prevent means because of identification. We have to identify whether it is a corona or not rapidly, and then we have to do the environmental sanitation, disinfection, sterilization, all these things we have to do. After that we have to control. So we have to control their infections. We advise them to wear a mask or something. Then here we may have to isolation, we have to isolate the patient. And then portal of entry. So definitely we have to maintain the hygienic conditions. So if they are diabetic, if they are things the cardiopulmonary, if they had more, they have to take more precautions. So courses of infection, incubation period, and we are having courses of infection like incubation period, prodermal stage and illness stage, and convalescent stage. So incubation period, entry of the pathogen into the body. So incubation period is nothing but the entry of the organism into the body and first appearance of the symptoms. So this is the prodermal, means microorganisms will grow and multiply and capable to spread to the other persons. Development of non-specific symptoms. So here non-specific symptoms can be seen to specific symptoms. Illness stage means manifestations of the signs and symptoms to the specific type of infection. Convalescent stage means acute symptoms. These acute symptoms will disappear. Length of recovery depends upon the severity of infection. It may depend. So these are the things. So you learn these terms very clearly. Incubation period means entrance of the pathogen into the body and appearance of the first infection. Prodermal stage means microorganism grow, it will grow and multiply, capable to spread. So illness stage means these manifestations, these can be seen, signs and symptoms can be seen to the that particular type of infection. Convalescent stage means acute symptoms will disappear. Length of recovery depends upon the severity of infections. So So we'll go with the wound infection. So wound healing process. So wound, what is meant by wound? Wound is a break in the continuity of the tissues. So it is a cut in the continuing in the bony structures, or internally, maybe internally it may can be caused by the externally by the physical things. The wound is a disruption or continuity in the regulatory process of the tissue cells. This is the definition. This wound has been classified according, it has many classifications. The wound has been classified, so we'll see one by one according to the status of the skin integrity. So depending upon the integrity, it may be open wound or closed wound. Open wound means there will be destruction of the skin and mucosa. Open wound lo the skin mucosa will be destruction. And example, trauma is then sharp objects. Closed wound, it may be burnt injury, no break, twisting and staining. Causes of the wound. What are the causes of the wound? Means depending upon the causes of the wound, it was divided into intentional and unintentional. So intentional means due to some specific reason or due to some specific cause, so aseptically they will do. So like surgical, aseptic precautions. So intention. So we are having any problem. So at that time, intentionally we'll go for the surgery or things. So that is a surgical incision, or vein puncture is also one of the examples. Unintentional means traumatic wound or accidental wound, unsterile environment, because of unsterile environment, and knife or burns. Mechanism of the injury. Depending upon the mechanism of injury, there will be lacerated wounds and contused wounds, incised wounds and abrupt wounds. So this lacerated wounds in the tissue or torn apart. So the tissue will become turned apart and has a gouged and irregular edges. So it will be turned apart and having a with irregular, that is nothing but the lacerated wound. So it takes longer than the incised to heal. So it will, because of irregular edges, because of turned apart, it may take long time. It may be due to because of a knife, blunt injury or any broken things. So it may lead to thing. Contused wound means no break in the skin. There will be no break, just they will be having a swelling, bruise and pain, discoloration can be seen. In case of any instrument or forcefully, if they throw the instrument, at that time this contused wound can be seen. Incisor wounds means clean and cut with smooth irregular edges. It may be very clean and having a smooth edges. So it may be this may heal very quickly because of this. So that may be in case of any razor type of thing or knife or glass injury occurs. With abrupt wound means superficial scraping. Abrupt means only just having a superficial scraping or rubbing. This may be due to because of any frictions in case of any small accidents. So severity of the, it may also divided into the severity of the injury. Severity of the injury, it may be a penetrating or perforating or puncture wound. So penetrating means it may penetrate into the deep tissues. Perforating means the foreign objects cut open the whole thickness of the wall and cavity of the pathogen. Whole thickness, it will cut whole thickness of the wall. It may just only enter it. Perforation means it may cut the thickness of the wall also. And puncture means just a small opening on the surface, just a very small. So and wound degree of contamination, depending upon the degree of contamination, it can be divided into clean wound, clean contaminated wound and contaminated wound, infected wound. So clean wound means it is a surgical wound or closed with closed drainage system. Clean contaminated wound means this is also one of the surgical thing. After doing any surgeries, it sometimes contaminated, at that time it called as a clean and contaminated wound. And contaminated wound means it may be open, it may be smelly, it may be very having a dirt particles may go and accommodate over there, it may lead to. For example, we can, in case of any invade open heart surgery, spillage of GI fluids, so when they at the spillage of water, at that time it may get contaminated. So in infected wounds, infected means because of dirt also. So these are the, it may divide, wound classification is divided into status of skin integrity, causes of the wound, mechanism of the injury, and it depends upon the severity of the injury and degree of contamination. The wound has been divided like this. We are having wound healing process. So wound healing process is blood clotting by provision of wound closure. So the blood will clot to how the wound will, whenever wound edana injury undi anante the blood will get clot. So that is the thing. So the, and then inflammatory phase, the next stage is the inflammatory phase, destructive phase. This destructive phase can be seen in 2 to 5 days. Inflammatory phase means that inflammatory reactions will occur. The destructive phase means 2 to 5 days. So inflammatory, where here the inflammatory phase get end and formation of the collagen can be slightly started. Proliferative phase means in this phase the new tissue will form. The new tissue is nothing but the granulation and it will be spreads and within 3 to 24 days. And maturation phase, in maturation phase definitely the wound get closed. So these are all the stages of process of healing. This the first blood clot on the wound, after that inflammatory, after that destructive, proliferatory and maturation phase. So these are the 5 stages of wound healing. So we are having factors influencing wound healing. So our general health, so if they are diabetic, if they are malignancies, their wound healing can be delayed. If they are smoking also, wound healing can be delayed. Age, so infants and geriatric people, they will having a deficit in immune system, so they will. And nutrition status also influences, because nutrition, the vitamin rich, if they take, so it may lead to, it may having a vitamin C, or will they take having green leaves, all these things which helps in wound healing. So that may cause, that may helps in quick healing of the thing. Obesity, the fat is one of the when it create, it may influence delay in healing. So that is the one. Fluid and electrolyte balance, the hydration is also very important thing. So if they have a hydration, this microorganisms will flush out from the kidney. So then definitely fluid and electrolyte balance should be maintained. In case of wound closure, so we definitely wound closure, it depends upon the wound, the suture material will, and then if it is open wound, we'll use absorbable materials, and sometimes nowadays the staples are getting, and skin adhesive nowadays, but small lacerations, some type of adhesives are seen, so that will be applied to that. So this is regarding the inflammation, infection and wound healing. This is the first year topics, so I had just reviewed this topics, so you can learn these things.